How to start with Burst.
Let's start with a summary. 1. Download and install the latest Qbundle. 2. Set up and create your wallet. 3. Acquire 2 Burst through faucets or the community. 4. Verify your account info by activating. 5. Set your reward recipient. 6. Plot your drives. 7. Start mining. And 8. Ensure you are always running the latest versions.
Whether you just want to run a wallet or get started with mining and plotting, your journey will begin on the official website, burst-coin.org. There you will have to download the necessary software. If you are using Windows, by far the easiest option is to download Qbundle, which automatically updates your software and downloads necessary files when called for. Once on the GitHub, please make sure you are downloading the latest version and go ahead and download the zip file. Unzip its contents to its own folder. Run burstwallet.exe. Qbundle will automatically check if all the necessary files are present. If not, you will be prompted to download these by clicking the Download Missing Components button. Click it and Qbundle will handle the rest. Once done, you will see green blocks to indicate Qbundle is ready. Hit continue. Most of the time, Windows will ask you if you allow Qbundle to access the internet. This is required. You are now entering the wallet. You can enter your passphrase here if you already have a wallet, or create a new one by clicking Create Account. Qbundle will generate your passphrase for your wallet. Store this securely. This is the only way to access your wallet. Please write it down somewhere. This is very important. Once you have done so, hit next and you will be asked to write your passphrase to check if you actually remembered the words correctly. Afterwards, you will see your wallet screen. It will try to run a local wallet and needs to download the blockchain. This is seen in the bottom of the screen and will take a while. You can speed up this process by downloading a pre-built copy of the blockchain by going into Database and clicking Import Database. If you have your own copy, you can select it here, but importing from repository is just as fine. Select one and start the import. This will severely speed up the synchronization process. If you don't feel like you want to run a local wallet, you can also access an online wallet. In the top of the screen, you can select which service you want to use for a wallet. An online wallet does not need a synced blockchain. Go ahead and select one if you want to access your wallet straight away. Note that you must have a running local wallet for solo mining, but not for pool mining. The online wallet will ask for your passphrase in order to access your account. Only give out your passphrase if you trust the source. You now have instant access to a working wallet. You can also store your passphrase in Qbundle, making it easily accessible for various features. Hit Account Management, Manage, and complete the form, giving your account a name and entering your phrase. It is now accessible throughout the program behind a secured PIN number. This is a good time to receive your first bursts, as you will need several to set up the wallet further. Go ahead and ask for bursts in one of our communities, like a Discord channel, or visit one of the faucets. After a while, you will be prompted with a message that your wallet does not have a public key yet. Verify your account by setting your account info. Note that this will cost one burst, but you will enhance your security. It may take a little while for the information to be checked and verified by the network. In order to start mining on a pool, it is now time to set a reward recipient. With solo mining, you are the recipient of the blocks you find, and this is default in Qbundle. However, pool mining is more interesting for most of us, as it shares blocks with a big group of users. You need to award any blocks you find to that pool so it can be shared with everyone. Under Tools, you will select your reward recipient. Enter your account, or select it from the three dots if you added your account to the account manager. Select a pool you would like to use, and select a wallet that is synced. If you are new, you can select the online wallet you just used to log in. Hit Select Reward Recipient and wait 4 blocks, or approximately 16 minutes, for it to be verified. This will also cost you 1 burst. We are now done spending bursts. It is time to make some bursts. In order to mine, you will first need to plot the hard disks you want to use for mining. This will take time, a lot of time, depending on the size of your hard disks and the speed of your processor, amongst other things. Please note that this is a one-time operation and will not have to be repeated ever. After this, mining is a simple process for both you and your computer. In Tools, hit Plotter. Select which drive you want to plot and make a subfolder in there, as it cannot plot straight to the root of the hard disk. Select your numeric ID or select an account from the account manager. Choose how big your plot should become and how many of your computer's resources it is allowed to use for the creation of the plots, and hit Start Plotting. If you already have existing plots, make sure they are reflected in the box below with My Plot Files. Otherwise, it will create duplicate plots, which will not work. If this is the first time you are plotting, Qbundle will ask you whether you want to download the files needed to run the plotter. You will need those files, so select yes. It will automatically download and install the necessary files. Let the program run for as long as it takes. Once finished, it is finally time to start mining. Your reward recipient change should be done, which can be checked in the reward recipient tool. Now hit miner in the tools tab. Here you can select whether you want to solo mine or pool mine. Note that solo mine is unavailable if your local wallet is not synced and running. For pool mining, make sure you select the same pool as you set your reward recipient to by hitting select predefined pool. Make sure the recipient is still correct and that all your plot files are reflected in the bottom box. If not, add them manually by hitting import plot files. Once set up, hit start mining. If this is the first time you are going to mine, Qbundle will prompt you to download the necessary files. These are required, so go ahead and let Qbundle set it up for you. Once done, you can finally begin mining. Note that depending on your plot size and the pool you have selected, it may take a while for you to get your first bursts. Please check with your pool to see if your shares are coming through to make sure everything is in order. That's it! You are now officially part of the Burst family. Please do check for updates from time to time under the files tab. This is a one-click process in Qbundle, and running the latest version is important to not miss out on any possible forks, bugs, or performance upgrades. Happy bursting!